हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ दीपक एंड वेलकम टू माई चैनल दीपक बायोलॉजी क्लासेस। तो फ्रेंड, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द थ्री डोमेन सिस्टम और वी कैन से सिक्स किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन। ओके, सो लेट मी रिमाइंड यू अबाउट माई लास्ट लेक्चर। तो इन माई लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द फाइव किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन। सो वी टेकर वॉट ही डिड, ही इंट्रोड्यूस्ड one more kingdom, that is fungi, into it, and then he became the five kingdom classification. So what was that? So in the five kingdom classification, the first one was Monera, then Protista, then fungi, then planting, and the last one was Animalia. Okay, so what Whittaker, what he did, he kept fungi as a separate kingdom. Okay, and then this kingdom becomes five kingdom, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it become total five kingdom. So in that, what he did in Monera, he kept Archaebacteria as well as Eubacteria. Okay, so he kept all the Archaebacteria and the Eubacteria in the kingdom Monera. Okay, so what were the criteria and on the basis of what he has classified? So he used like five criteria. The first one was cell wall structure based, means cell structure based. Second, mode of nutrition. Third, mode of reproduction. Fourth, thallus organization. And the fifth one is phylogenetic relationship. So on the basis of that, he has given five kingdom classification: Monera, Protista, Fungi, Planti, Animalia. So now, three domain system, or we can say six kingdom classification. Then another scientist, that is Carl Wurz, in 1990. Okay, then he came. Then he has given six kingdom classification. Okay, now how it becomes six kingdom? So whatever the Whittaker, he has kept Archaebacteria and the Eubacteria in the kingdom Monera. So Carl Wurz ne kya kiya, inhe hi kingdom bana diya. Okay, so kingdom, he made this Archaebacteria one kingdom, then Eubacteria second kingdom, then Protista third kingdom, fungi fourth kingdom, Plantis fifth kingdom, and Animalia sixth kingdom. Okay, so first kingdom, second kingdom, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Now it is six kingdom classification, which is given by Carl Wurz. So first kingdom Archaebacteria, second Eubacteria, third Protista, fourth fungi, fifth Planti, sixth Animalia. After that, what he did, then he has given this three domain system, means he has classified all six kingdom into three different domains. Okay, so we will talk about the domain. So three domain. Three domain system. Okay, so first one was Archaea, second one Bacteria, and the last one is Eukarya. Okay, so what he did, he classified this kingdom into domain, means इन्होंने क्या किया, ये जो Archaebacteria है इसका एक domain बना दिया, means जितने भी primitive जो भी prokaryotic organisms unicellular, he has kept into Archaea. Okay, Archaea, this is domain one. Then Eubacteria, or we can say the modern bacteria, it comes under the domain Bacteria 2, Bacteria, and then the last domain, that is Eukaryote. So all these organisms, starting from Protista, Fungi, Animalia, so he made all these kingdom into domain 3, that is Eukaryote. So this Eukarya include all the eukaryotic organisms, that is Protista, Fungi, Planti, Animalia. Okay, understood? एक मैं और बता देता हूँ, जितने भी आर्की बैक्टीरिया है इसका एक सेपरेट डोमेन बना दिया, जिसे आर्किया डोमेन बोलते हैं। सेकेंड डोमेन क्या था, बैक्टीरिया और द यू बैक्टीरिया। ओके, इसमें क्या है, जितने मॉडर्न बैक्टीरिया हैं विच हैव द एबिलिटी टू डू फोटोसिंथेसिस एज वेल एज देयर मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इज हेटरोट्रॉफिक आल्सो। तो ही केप्ट ऑल दोज ऑर्गेनिज्म इनटू बैक्टीरिया एंड देन द रिमेनिंग फोर किंगडम दैट इज प्रोटिस्टा फंजाई प्लांटी एनिमेलिया दीज ऑल आर यूकैरियोटिक ऑर्गेनिज्म। तो ही केप्ट ऑल दीज फोर किंगडम इनटू वन डोमेन दैट इज यूकैरिया। अंडरस्टूड? ओके, सो नाउ वी विल डिस्कस लाइक ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ व्हाट ही हैज गिवन दिस थ्री डोमेन सिस्टम। ओके, सो थ्री डोमेन सिस्टम So what were the criteria? Now the question comes like why he has separated the archaea and the bacteria two separate domain. Okay, so there is one most important criteria and that criteria was 16S ribosomal RNA. Okay, so what is this 16S ribosomal RNA? So it's a part of ribosome. So जैसा कि मैंने बताया जो prokaryotes होते हैं उनके अंदर जो unit उसके अंदर जो ribosome होता है वो 70S होता है, means 70S ribosome is present. Okay, it is also having two subunit 50S and 30S. Okay, तो ये तो 16S है subunit, ये क्या है, it's a component of small subunit of 30S. Okay, so ये 16S है, ये क्या है, ये इसका कंपोनेंट ऑफ द स्मॉल सब यूनिट ऑफ 30S। अब एक बात देखने वाली है, जितने भी आर्किया बैक्टीरिया है और हम जो कह सकते हैं बैक्टीरिया है उनके अंदर क्या है, 16S राइबोसोमल आरएनए का जो है वो सीक्वेंस प्रेजेंट होता है। ओके, ये बहुत ही स्पेशल फीचर है और इस 16S राइबोसोमल आरएनए सीक्वेंसेस की बेस पे क्या किया था, कार्ल वुज ने थ्री डोमेन सिस्टम दिया था। अब आर्किया के अंदर भी 16S राइबोसोमल आरएनए जीन प्रेजेंट है, ओके, बैक्टीरिया के अंदर भी प्रेजेंट है जीन सीक्वेंसेस, ओके, सो बोथ आर्किया एंड यूबैक्टीरिया दे आर हैविंग दिस 16S राइबोसोमल आरएनए जीन सीक्वेंसेस, ओके, दीज आर स्पेशलाइज्ड सीक्वेंसेस व्हिच इज प्रेजेंट ओनली इन द आर्किया बैक्टीरिया एंड द यूबैक्टीरिया, ओके, सो क्या किया, अब इसका काम क्या होता है, these are special type of sequences which is present only in archaea and the eubacteria or we can say modern bacteria, so these sequences helps in identifying the bacteria at the species level, okay, so these 16S ribosomal RNA gene sequences helps in identifying the bacteria at a species level. Okay, so suppose अगर आपने किसी भी suppose आपने किसी ocean से या किसी soil से या different states की soil से आपने अगर किसी bacteria को isolate किया है और आप देखना चाहते हैं कि हमने जो bacteria isolate किया है क्या वो novel है या हमने कोई ऐसा तो नहीं कोई हमने नई स्पीसीज जो है वो डिस्कवर कर ली है, तो उसके लिए आपको क्या करना पड़ता है, 16S दैट इज 16S राइबोसोमल आरएनए सीक्वेंसिंग करानी होती है, ठीक है, जैसे ही आप 16S राइबोसोमल आरएनए सीक्वेंसिंग कराएंगे तो आपको पता चलेगा जो आपका बैक्टीरिया है वो स्पीसीज लेवल पे नॉवल है कि नहीं, मतलब उसका स्पीसीज जो आपने क्या आपने जो स्पेसीज जो भी आपने आइसोलेट किया है वो नॉवल है कि नहीं, तो उसे जानने के लिए हम लोग क्या करते हैं 16S राइबोसोमल आरएनए सीक्वेंसिंग करते हैं, बिकॉज दीज 16S राइबोसोमल आरएनए जीन सीक्वेंसेस आर स्पेशलाइज्ड सीक्वेंसिंग एट इज प्रेजेंट ओनली इन द बैक्टीरिया एंड द आर्किया. ओके, सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस 16S राइबोसोमल आरएनए जीन सीक्वेंसेस कार्ल वुज हैज डिवाइडेड आर्किया इज वन डोमेन, बैक्टीरिया इज वन डोमेन एंड द अदर यूकैरियोटिक ऑर्गेनिज्म इन द अदर इन द डोमेन यूकैरिया. ओके, तो दीज आर हैविंग सिंगल यूनिसेलुलर ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड इन यूकैरियोट दे आर हैविंग द यूकैरियोटिक एंड मल्टीसेलुलर ऑर्गेनिज्म. ओके, सो नाउ दिस वन इज द इंपॉर्टेंट क्राइटेरिया ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस 16S राइबोसोम आरएनए. ही हैज गिवन थ्री डोमेन, आर्किया, बैक्टीरिया एंड द यूकैरियोट. सो नाउ वी विल सी द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द आर्किया, बैक्टीरिया एंड द यूकैरियोट, लाइक ऑन द व्हाट आर द डिफरेंसेस ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ वी कैन क्लासिफाई, वी कैन डिवाइड दीज आर्किया, बैक्टीरिया एंड यूकैरिया इनटू सेपरेट डोमेन. So let's see the differences. So bacteria, archaea and then eukarya. Okay, so these are three domains and now we will see that what are the difference between these three domains. Okay, so first one, these are prokaryotic. Then archaea, they are also prokaryotic. And then eukaryote, they are eukaryotic organism. Then these prokaryote, they are unicellular. They are also unicellular. They are multicellular. Okay. Then in prokaryote, in bacteria, no two nucleus. Here also no two nucleus present. In this, well developed nucleus present. Okay, next is what? No cellular organelle. Here also no cell organelles. Here cell organelles present. Okay, next, seventy S ribosome. Here also 70S ribosome. Here 80S ribosome. Here the genome is circular. Here also circular genome. In this, linear genome is present. Okay, then they are antibiotic antibiotic sensitive. These are antibiotic resistance. These are also antibiotic resistance. तो सेल वॉल किसका बना होता है इसमें? पेप्टाइडोग्लाइकन. हियर स्यूडोम्यूरिन. हियर स्यूडोम्यूरिन. इन दिस इट डिफेंड्स लाइक इन प्लांट इट इज सेलुलोज और इन फंजाई काइटिन. तो वी कैन से cellulose or chitin. Okay, then in their cell wall is peptidoglycan, archaea, pseudomurine, and then eukaryote, cellulose or chitin. So lipid membrane is Stirling. Here in archaea it is Etherling, and in eukaryotic also it is Stirling. Okay, now RNA polymerase, it is one. It is one. Here several, and in eukaryote it is three. Okay, and some there are some others also, like in bacteria the protein initiator is N-formyl methionine. In archaea, it is methionine, and in eukaryote also it is methionine. Okay, so these are some of the like important differences which we can see between the bacteria, archaea, and eukaryote. Okay, so along with that, there are some other differences also. Okay, so now we will see the differences. So the first one is prokaryotic organism, means all the bacteria are prokaryotic in nature. In archaea also they are prokaryotic, they are primitive, and in eukaryota they are eukaryotic organism, means they are having some modern organism. Next, they are unicellular, all the bacteria are unicellular. Archaea is also unicellular, but in case of eukaryote they are multicellular. Next, no two nucleus, means in bacteria their genetic material is not enclosed by any type of membrane. Okay, so no two nucleus is present. Same case is with archaea also, no two nucleus, and eukaryotic well developed nucleus present, means it is having the nuclear membrane, means their genetic material i.e. DNA or RNA it is enclosed by a nuclear membrane. Okay, next, no cell organelles, means in bacteria no cell organelles are present, like the Golgi bodies, endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria. Same case with archaea also, and in eukaryota all the cell organelles are present. Next, in bacteria the ribosome is of 70S type, means it includes two subunits, 15S, 50S and the 30S. And in case of archaea also it is 70S ribosome, and in eukaryote it is 80S ribosome, means it is having two subunits, one is 60S and another one is 40S. So these two subunits are there. Next, all the bacteria, they are having the circular genome, means they are having the circular RNA. And these bacteria, they don't have any introns. Okay, along with that, archaea also having the circular genome, and in case of eukaryote, their genome is linear, okay, and they are having introns, okay. Next, bacteria are antibiotic sensitive. Suppose if you give some antibiotic like the penicillin, then it affect the cell wall, okay. So all these bacteria, they are antibiotic sensitive, and in case of archaea, they are antibiotic resistant. Means this character is resembles with the eukaryotic character, okay. So in archaea, if you give the antibiotic like the penicillin, then in these archaea, they don't have effect of this antibiotic. And in case of eukarya also, no antibiotic effect is there, but there are some eukaryotic antibiotic, which antibiotics are there, which can affect the eukaryotic organism, okay. Next, peptidoglycan. So in bacteria, the cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan, means they are having two important substances. One is NAM, yani N-acetylmuramic acid, and the another one is N-acetylglucosamine. So both these substances, they form the peptidoglycan in case of bacteria. Next, in archaea, no such peptidoglycan is present. They are having some glycoproteins, okay. So we can say that the cell wall of archaea is made up of pseudomedin, okay. And in case of eukarya, it like depends. Like if the plant cell wall is there, then it is made of cellulose, and if it is fungi cell wall, then it is made of chitin. Next, the lipid membrane is ester linked, means जो bacteria होते हैं उनके जो lipid membrane है, it is ester linked, and in case of archaea, it is ethyl linked. That's why these archaea, they are also present in very extreme environment, okay, like the halophiles, thermophiles, okay. So these archaea, they have a tendency to present in the extreme environment because of this ethyl linked membrane. Ethylene lipid membrane, they are able to survive in those environment, okay. While in case of eukaryote, it is ester linked. Now we talk about the RNA polymerase. So in the bacteria, the RNA polymerase is only one RNA polymerase is present. In archaea, it is of several types, yani several RNA polymerase present. And in case of eukaryote, it is three RNA polymerase, like RNA polymerase 1, 2, and 3. Next, we will talk about the protein initiator molecule. So N-methylmorpholmethionine, it's an amino acid, okay. It is responsible to initiate the protein synthesis in case of bacteria. And archaea, it is methionine, and in eukaryotic, it is methionine. Okay, so these are the some of the differences between the archaea, bacteria, and the eukaryote. Now, if we see according to phylogenetic relationship, okay, then we can see that this is bacteria, this is archaea, and this one is eukarya. So this phylogenetic tree, how can be made? So this phylogenetic tree we can make by using the 16S ribosomal RNA data. Okay, on the basis of that, we can make this phylogenetic tree. So in the phylogenetic tree, we can see that this archaea is closely resembling, like present to the eukaryote. That's why it is showing the character of some eukaryotics also. Like it is having, like it is antibiotic resistance. Okay, like it's protein initiator is methionine. This methionine is this amino acid is responsible, and it helps in the protein initiator. So according to the phylogenetic tree, this archaea shows some close resemblance with the eukaryotes. Okay, so these are some of the important differences through which we can differentiate between the bacteria, archaea, and the eukarya. Okay, so here my video has finished. So if you like the video, then share it, and if you are new to my channel, then please subscribe. Thank you.